Hello, Indy Labbers. I'm Rich Lund, and it's time to put the science in your hands. In some recent episodes of Indy Labs, we've seen that the motion of magnets can produce some electric currents. Well, I'm willing to bet 20 pounds that the opposite is true, and that we could get electric currents to produce magnetic fields, which could then produce motion. Well, actually, that 20-pound bet wouldn't be a fair one, because by 1821, Michael Faraday himself had already demonstrated this principle and paved the way for the DC electric motor. DC standing for direct current and AC standing for alternating current. Direct current is what every battery uses, whereas alternating current is probably the kind of current that you have running through your house. Well, with just a few household items and those neodymium magnets that we've been using lately, we can make our own DIY electric motor. And we'll also dive a little bit into how it actually works. Here's what you're gonna need. Get yourself one D-cell battery, two rubber bands, and two paper clips, some very thin enameled copper wire. I'm using a gauge of wire that is AWG24. AWG stands for American Wire Gauge. It's approximately half a millimeter in diameter. And it's also really important that it's enameled. This means to insulate it, instead of covering it up with plastic or rubber, there's a very thin layer of enamel. This is important because we're going to have to scrape some of it off, but not all of it. And then also, the special ingredient, get yourself a six-pack of neodymium magnets if you haven't yet. These things are great to have around, and there's plenty of Indy Labs that you can do with them. All right, got what you need? Let's get directly into it. All right, first, we need to coil our wire. So that means you're going to need something round to wrap it around. I found that a paper towel core works pretty good. Make sure you give yourself plenty of extra wire at the end. You want to wrap it a good number of times, but not too many because you don't want to make it too heavy. I'm doing 25 winds for mine. Just like before, give yourself plenty of extra wire and then trim it off. Once you've got your wire coiled, gently try to take it off of whatever you wrapped it around. Then, while you're holding it tight, you're going to take both ends and one at a time. Do another half wind, but you're going to wrap it around the coil as you do. This is going to help keep the coil together. Do this at both ends, and you should still have some more excess wire to use. Okay, so your coil's made. Go ahead and set that aside for a minute. Next up, the paper clips. For starters, take the outside loop of the paper clip and straighten it out completely as best you can. Do this to both of your paper clips. Then, with the upper loop, you're going to want to bend it up. So you make a higher up little cradle. That's where your wire is going to lay. Though it can be done by hand, you might want to get some pliers for this one. They don't have to be perfectly identical. Don't worry, we'll be able to adjust later on. Next up, take those rubber bands and wrap them lengthwise around your battery. Start with one and make sure that the rubber bands are touching the two ends of the battery. Wrap the second one around on top of that, and you're going to try to make a bit of an X. Your rubber bands are going to hold your paper clips in place, and they also prevent your battery from rolling around. Now, wiggle in the long part of your paper clips underneath the rubber bands, one on each end. Okay, next step, and this one's really important. Looking at your coil, choose one end of it to be the bottom of your coil. Whatever end that is, you're going to need to scrape off the enamel from the bottom ends of the two wires that are sticking out. You don't want to scrape any enamel off from the top, only the bottom. A knife works best, so kids, if you're doing this at home, make sure that you've got your parents helping you with this part. Carefully and gently scrape off the enamel so you're exposing the copper only on the bottom part of that end of the wire. And then do this to the other end as well. These two ends are going to be supported by our paper clips that we bent. As long as you only scrape the enamel off of the bottom, then only when the coil is in the downward position will there be a connection in our circuit. When the coil is rotated any other direction, then the circuit will turn off. By holding your coil up to where the paper clips are, you can kind of see where it's going to rest. And this is a chance also to trim off any of the excess ends that you don't actually need. Okay, now for the final ingredient, our neodymium magnets. Depending upon how high up your paper clip holds are, you might need just two or three, maybe four or five neodymium magnets. You want to get the magnets close to the bottom of the coil of the wire, but not touching it. Now carefully thread the ends of your coiled wires into where the paper clips are going to hold them. And if you did things right, your motor should already start to fidget around and maybe even take off. If nothing's happening, then try flipping your magnets upside down. It's a little bit touchy. You may need to adjust things a little bit. I know I had to. But once I got it right, check out what happened. Wow! Look at that baby purr. Now, because it's in motion, a little bit of that wobbling can sometimes undo the fine-tuning. So feel free to take things or glue them into a more permanent position if you wish. In theory though, as long as your battery still has enough of a charge, your motor would continue to keep on going. It would last until the battery runs out of current. Alright, so what's happening here? How does this work? Well, when the coil is in the downward position and the circuit is connected, then electrons are flowing through our electric current, and they're all going in that same coil direction. As we've talked about in previous Indy Labs, when you have a moving current, well, it produces its own magnetic field. As long as your magnets are facing in the right way, so that way they're going to repel that field, well then they give your coil a bit of a push, like pushing a kid on a swing set. Once the coil gets the push though, well then that's rotating our wire ends, and so the current, because of the enamel, stops being connected. The electric current is gone, so is the magnetic field. But the momentum from that push keeps the coil rotating, and eventually it rotates all the way back down, so that way the circuit is connected again, and the entire cycle just repeats. Every time it rotates, it connects the circuit, which produces a magnetic field, which gets another push from the magnetic field due to our magnets. Pretty cool, huh? Hey, I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Indy Labs, and if you did, that thumbs up like is always appreciated. And we'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Let us know how this experiment went for you, and if you've got any ideas for some science topics you'd like to see us explore, we love taking requests. And don't put those magnets away yet! Some more Indy Labs involving electricity and magnetism, they're on the horizon. So subscribe to the channel now so you don't miss out. I'm Rich Lund, thanks for watching, I'll catch you next time. All night, all night.